Good morning, everybody, and welcome to this short workshop. I'm very happy that Professor Ramadevi has been able to join us, and Manjanaika and Dr. Barve will be conducting this. Dr. Das is engaged in another important cultural activity. I think there is a children's competition going on in the convocation hall. So he said he will join us very shortly, another 10-15 minutes, but we thought we will not delay the proceeding. I have something very little to say. This is actually the beginning of a series of national workshops which we'll be conducting using our T10KT methodology, where we train 10,000 people at a time. We have to train more than 1 lakh library staff across the country within 1 year. In use of Koha. Ministry of Culture has standardized Koha as the software, because there is no software license cost. One of the biggest advantages is we don't pay license cost, and plus there is a uniformity across the country. Now we have our system already in place, which we have built over lots of years, but conversion to Koha is under active consideration of the committee, and the committee will take its decision. After that, it may usually take 5 to 6 months to convert all our metadata into Koha format. But more importantly, once we do that, our library content would then become visible across the country because of the coordinated activity that is happening under the NVLI project. As I told you, the National Virtual Library of India is being built, and IIT Bombay is the coordinating institute. So the software is being developed by CDAC. The Koha-based cleansing process for the metadata is being handled by IGNU, by Mrs. Suma Kanjila. And we have to build the cloud on which the entire data for the National Virtual Library will reside. So you'll be happy to know that that cloud is being built in IIT Bombay as we speak. Tendering process is going on, and we will have 3 petabytes of storage to store cultural content. I don't know whether you are aware of what petabyte is. So you know megabytes, right? Megabytes is generally you measure your videos or pictures or some such thing. So 1,000 megabytes is 1 gigabyte. 1,000 gigabytes is 1 terabyte. And 1,000 terabytes is 1 petabyte. This is the largest storage cloud in any academic institute in the country when it is established, and we propose to inaugurate it in May. And I have promised the Secretary of Culture that our library will be one of the first ones to go onto the cloud. Of course, after the cloud is established, the software is released, there is a lot of activity, by which time we should be ready. Now, since I have taken the responsibility of training 1 lakh library staff, I thought we will start with our own library. So this, you people, whatever feedback that you gave in this short training, we will actually take that feedback, modify the course structure appropriately so that it can be done using MOOCs, that subsequent training, using massive open online courses. Some of you we might request to work as our associate faculty to monitor the discussion forum where people will ask questions. Here you can ask questions directly, and when people are away, they can ask questions only by typing them. So there will be lots of interesting things that will happen, and I'm very happy that you are going to be the pioneering batch in the country for this large cultural activity. I must also thank Dr. Manjanaika and her for she just mentioned that she works in National Chemical Laboratory, and NCL library has just gone live with Koha yesterday. So that's a good sign. So thank you very much, ma'am, for coming here. And I'm very grateful to Professor Ramadevi. On a weekend, she found time to spare time with us. I'll request her to say a few words.
Professor Patak, without him, I think we should come into limelight. We should be the first institute amongst IITs, NITs and IISCs to start implementing COA as early as possible. Let's learn all the tools. All of you put in full mind into it and learn all the tools which is going to be taught by Sunita. So she's really, you know, she has been working on it for the last several years and she knows inside out. And such an opportunity, I don't think any of you will get anywhere. So please make use of it at full swing. Learn every bit of it, ask her every questions, clarify, and be part of the MOOC as volunteers or participants or adjunct faculty to help others all over India so that we really have taken this drive and let's all put in all our 100% effort into it. Thank you. Thank you, Professor Patik. Yeah.
May I request Dr. Barve to share some of her initial thoughts, although she'll be speaking to you throughout the day, but on this occasion.
Hello, good morning. I have been conducting COA workshops for last several years and it's been hard to convince your own peers as well as the laymans. So as Dr. Patak has taken an initiative and all of you have gathered here, I'm sure all of you will start liking COA software, because once you like, then you try to know more. That's very important and it's very simple, and certainly proprietary software has to go out from the library community. That's very important. And why COA is, many people ask, why COA? I mean, why there are so many other good software available in the market, why we are promoting COA? First thing is functionality point of view, we should see that, and it has a base of international standards. So maybe today COA is good, tomorrow something better than COA comes into the market, we should be able to move from COA. But otherwise, let me tell you, yesterday only we have gone live in NCL for COA, and really we had very tough time going from whatever software we were using. It was a tough time for us to really move, and let me tell you very honestly, we could not get 100% out of it. So if I would have continued still further with that existing software, I would have had really great difficulty and would have spent unnecessary lot of money, and the output would have not been really achieved. And as you know, many countries now, many states now are making it mandatory that they should use only COA. So if IIT has taken an initiative, we also have to accept that initiative and go forward to it, learn it. It's very simple software. By within half a day sessions, which I will be conducting in the afternoon, I know you will be understanding all the modules. So there won't be many questions, but certainly as MOOC is going to be there, you will, whatever queries you will have in future, they can be sorted out easily. So I hope soon IIT library also will move to COA, and all of we would be part of this movement which is happening in the library science profession. Thank you for giving me opportunity to come here and share my thoughts.
I just want to add one.
Yeah.
So I think whatever existing we are doing on LibSuit or LibSys, I want you to do, all of you after learning this, if you can contribute to parallelly doing COA. It'd be nice, and once we are completely convinced COA can take over everything, we will switch over to COA. If the institute, you know, the ERP, everything, permission happens, we will get to it.
I'll add a couple of things here. She mentioned COA as if COA is the only thing and something is wrong with the other pieces of software. So software is something which I understand rather well. I've been working with it for 40 years. So let me tell you that we are functional people. Your job is to handle library, the other people whose job is to handle accounts, somebody else is handling stores. You must have heard of ERP package that is going on that madam just mentioned. Now, in this context, it should be understood that there will be different pieces of software. Some software will be charged software because people have spent time and money to develop that. And there is absolutely nothing wrong with commercial products. Wherever we need, we have to adopt commercial products. Wherever we can adopt open source products. The open source products suffer from one problem sometimes, that if there is no community to support that product, then if there are problems, there is nobody to solve those problems. However, COA comes under that category, like Linux operating system or MySQL database, where there is a very large community of developers, programmers, who are working to enrich that software perpetually. And that is the reason why the ministry has chosen COA, and the world over, the moment is to choose COA. Another advantage of choosing a common system is that exchangeability of information enhances significantly. So I would like to, in conclusion, say that there is nothing wrong with Libsys. Libsys is being used by many people in the world. But nation is taking a standardization step and we wish to move towards that. Second thing I would like to mention is, whenever you shift from one system to another, invariably our mind will compare the user interaction that was there in my earlier system and that will there now. The institute is facing this problem in adopting ERP. Because you know that we have computerization in many places already. The Dean R&D's interface, for example, which we use for sponsored projects, is found so convenient. Now, anytime the ERP fellow comes and says, aisa nahi, aisa karna padega, our mind says, why this nonsense? I was doing it easily with this system. Why do I have to adopt this system? You will realize that any system that you adopt for the first time will always have this problem. Recall the days when Libsys was implemented. Was it all hunky-dory? Immediately you could start working. All of you had to spend some time to get acclimatized to that kind of interface. So this is natural. So I'll repeat two things. Number one, there is nothing wrong in commercial products being used. There is nothing wrong in open source product being used. When we use something, we should decide on the basis of what is most useful, what is most economical, and what permits us to go forward in life along with other similar people. It is from that point of view that libraries in India and libraries world over are moving towards this. As I said, there will be some activity subsequently, and I really admire the suggestion made by Professor Rama Devi that you should actually start working using Koha, which means much even before the institute takes a decision, or rather, to facilitate the right decision, it might be useful for at least some of you to start. There is some activity that has already started. If you can buttress that, and then since you all know existing system, you will be the best people to tell how the problems are coming while transferring data from this to that system, how those problems are being resolved. And we will all benefit from that, and the nation will benefit, because exactly similar questions are being asked in thousands of libraries across the country. And if we can be the pioneers to help them understand what are the problems and what are the solutions, then we could make all such solutions contributed by you or all such problems identified by you, properly acknowledging who has contributed what, we'll make all of that part of our open source lessons so that people in the country, when they use our online courses and others, they will not only see just the lectures and other things, they will also see contributions from you saying you had system A, you tried to move to system B, these were the problems that you faced, this is how the problems were resolved, so that we can also take a proper decision and it will be helpful. So thank you very much, madam, for it. So without further ado, I was just waiting for Dr. Das to come in. Whenever he comes, I'll request him to speak a few words. He is busy in, as I said, it's an important activity. All of us had children participating in school competitions. And you know how important for children it is for the parents to be present. For them, it's a unique event. So he called me, in fact, and I told him, please don't rush. Spend time with in the competition and then come. He'll come there. But I thought, in the inaugural function, at least a cup of tea is given to people? Or tea is arranged? Okay. Since we have some time, I would like to pass on the mic because each participant, and I must tell you, I was quite surprised that so many participants came forward to invest one of their weekend times on this activity. It's very encouraging, man. I'll pass on this mic. And if you could kindly just tell me your name and what activity you handle, I'll be very happy. This will be kind of introduction. And this will also get recorded as a part of this.
Hello, everybody. I am L.P. Ingole, Assistant Librarian, Central Library.
Pralat Kishan Salve, working in Central Library.
Nilesh Ramdas Aire, Xerox Section, Central Library. Rajesh Sarmalkar, reference section.
Vilas Kapsi, circulation counter, circulation section.
Manohar Pujari, working in circulation section.
Sriram Tatkare, working circulation section.
Kailash Kevle, working in journal section.
Hanuman Sonar, working journal section.
Rajesh Jadhav from pamphlet section.
Myself Jitendra Jain, working in technical processing section and doing the classification and cataloging for new books and other pro.
Catalog one book wrongly.
Yes sir, it is important. It is the backbone of the library, that's why.
Good morning to all. Myself Kadam Mashruwala. I am working in book acquisition section. Before 2 days earlier I was in circulation section, and we are doing so many cataloging correction at a time when the we received the book when it will return, and so many problems we are facing at the some jaise ISA means standards number hai to wo series mein aa jata hai wo sab bahut sara gadbad hai data to jitna bhi humse rectify hota hai sir hum karte hain. And we have already started the journal section entry, means journals ka earlier I was in journal section, then we have already started in Koha entry, and we have already entered the newspaper entry in Koha also. So daily basis we have record. If the newspaper will not come, we will less the money from the bill. That kind of activities we have already done in journal section.
Hello, good morning everybody. Myself Anil Patnaik. We are maintaining 20,000 online journals, and also using Koha software there, and we are maintaining all the billing and certified everything we are doing there, only. So we are maintaining 17 crores journals.
Myself Shankar Behra, circulation section.
Myself Niskatan Viswal, working in book acquisition section.
Myself Akhilesh Dove, I am system admin central library.
I am TN Adhikari, working in central library circulation section.
My name is Vishwas Sundam Katkole. I am working as a binder and take all the help to all the library as run well and good in our IIT.
I am DB Kamble, working in circulation section, library information office.
Myself Dipti Chaurasia, I am working in technical processing section.
Good morning all. Myself Anita Narvade, I am working as a technical assistant in SOM library.
I am Vatsala Surarkar, I am working in book acquisition section.
I am Vrunda Vishwas Katkole, working in IIT Culture Association Library in public library.
My name is Naina Menon. I am working in circulation section.
Myself Fati Bhuir, junior assistant in librarian's office.
Good morning all. Myself Samruddhi Havaldar. I am working in reference section and handling electronic thesis and dissertations.
Hello, I am Mrs. Sharma, working in pamphlet section. That is a report and report section and thesis and dissertation section.
My name is Garima Sarva.
My name is Tejar Rajaram Mahadi, TPS section, book processor.
My name is Kalpana Ravindra Patil. I am working binding section.
Chandrakala Prabhakar Sadhevi, pamphlet section.
Good morning all. I am Mangesh Vairam Gaikwad, working in library office.
Good morning everyone. My name is Dadu Janu Jangle. I am working in circulation section.
I am Kishore Gorule. I am working in circulation section.
I was searching for a book in the rack and I found a smart undergraduate student who took a book from one of the shelves, and instead of going to the circulation counter, those days you have to sign and there was, he quietly went to another shelf and kept that book there. And I could not understand why he was doing that. I said, why that book was wrongly kept there? He smiled and he says, no, that book is in heavy demand, but I do not have my quota. So if I come tomorrow, I'll not find the book, but nobody else will find it till tomorrow. Now, this is equivalent to wrong classification. I mean, this was physical asset wrongly being classified. But let me tell you that information that you collect, whether it is technical processing or subsequently, or as you said, so much corrections to be done, one wrong piece of information that gets associated with book or journal, in the digital world, believe me, nobody in the world can find it out ever. So it is that bad. It's like a accounting entry not being properly done. What would happen to our accounts? It's almost that. So what you people are doing truly is very, very important. You are the custodians of knowledge for all future generations. And one of the correct things that you do will help people to quickly find it out. Our ambition is that by next year, when much of the metadata is collected, we would be able to say, this particular book, there are 217 copies of that book in India, and these are with the following 100 libraries. So if you have a book which perhaps is not available at many places, somebody in Kolkata or Coimbatore would be able to search on the NVLI and say, oh, this book exists in IIT Bombay library, then they can write to you, request for a book. Today, it is not possible to know which book, which journal is where, easily. So that is the ambition. And I'm very thankful to all of you because you are pioneering this, and this work will be helpful, particularly for us to understand where the difficulties lie. Thank you so much. I invite you all to join us for a cup of tea.